No one likes a nosy neighbor. Aphid on the move. Give me a second to let my eyes adjust to that. Putting on some more armor. Taking a look around. Got a new one here. Wonder what these ants are up to in the sandbox. This is a lot easier than lab. I always thought the miniatures were kind of cool, but seeing them at this scale gives you a totally different perspective. No wonder Pete likes his stuff.
Science!
Check out that bee!
Ugh!
Science!
Wonder what these ants are up to in the sandbox. That is one giant statue of a weird Ant-Man.
Science! Science!
There's a lot of junk in this sandbox. Nothing like a little science, as I always say. Taking a look around.
Yeah!
Aphid on the move.
Hope this is enough to keep me safe.
Dominant Practical Technologies, Dr. Wendell Tully, science... scratch that. Dr. Wendell Tully, PhD. At least they can't fire me for that. My years of work on the spacer mattered little, Dominant. The project was shut down and I was shown the door. And yet, Kaminsky still works there, and he's an idiot. I've been reduced to substitute teaching at the local school. How many times can one person be expected to explain the difference between a vector and a scalar? If it has direction, then it's a scalar. I mean, a vector. Oh! I swear the ignorance around me is contagious. Does that normal teacher do anything? No wonder my inventions cannot be appreciated. Our society no longer understands science. Omnit Practical Technologies, Dr. Wendell Tolley, Science Division, log 88.06.23A. Finally, my genius is recognized. My Omnit Minders have requested a demonstration of the spacer. I do wonder how they even found out about it. No doubt it was the loose lips of that blabbing Klein. But perhaps his indiscretion has worked in my favor in this instance, and I will have the last laugh. Once Omnit sees what I have accomplished here, I will prove that their many years of investment in me was not a mistake. How it will feel to have them watch me in my moment of triumph. This is what I have been working toward my entire career. Recognition at last.
Good thing I'm hungry.
Supplemental log, Omnit Practical Technologies, Tolly. Oh, whatever, I'll sort it later. The important thing is I have done it! Success! The spacer has worked its magic. I have successfully shrunk a set of basic plastic polyhedral dice from the size of standard dice to no bigger than the size of, well, much smaller dice. Burgle, make a note to come up with a better comparison.
Noting!
You did it. Nonetheless, this is a complete exoneration. However, it occurs to me that I have a new problem. The dice were intended to be young Fo's Christmas present. He will be disappointed. But perhaps I can convince him that they were miniature dice. The tiny instructions might be a bit of a giveaway. A new solution may be required. To the Fun Pit Toy Mart before they close!
Taking a look around. Thank you.
putting on some more armor.
Dominant Practical Technologies, Dr. Wendell Tully, Science Division, log 88.07.01. First test demonstration of the spacer. Director Dalton Schmechter in attendance. Begin recording. Everyone, thank you for coming. Today, I will show you nothing less than a quantum leap forward in technology. This is the spacer. It is a machine that has the power to shrink any object many times over, unleashing the power of the miniature world. Now, I'm sure that some of you will be skeptical, but I have no doubt that a demonstration of this device will show you a vision of the future, of Ominous future, of our future. Now, if you will all put on your peeper goggles, I'll begin the demonstration. Behold, the future! Please stay in your seats. This is a minor issue, I assure you. Just give me a moment. I can fix this. I can fix this.
See what we can find. Light. Burn back the shadows and turn away the empty dust. New one found. Watch out. That ant means business.
Transcription Unit 90.5.1. Order number 43.
Do it again, Burgle, for old time's sake.
What's that, Dr. Tully?
Play the old script.
Right away! Hello, and welcome to Robius Classic Automated Order Shop. My name is Burgle, and I will be taking your order today. Perhaps I can interest you in the daily specials? My favorite is the Ruby's 0.375 pounder with cheese with a side of mammal-style fries.
That will do just fine, Burgle.
Remember the Ruby Burger motto! Make every day exponentially great!
Taking a look around, got a new one here. Worker Black Hand here. I read that extended periods of isolation in remote places can be pretty hard to cope with. Is surprisingly not terrible.
Thank you.
Science!
Scientists make this look harder than it is.
Virgil, I'd like to summarize the results of today's mixer trials.
Ready to take your dictation!
Trials 1 and 2 were aborted due to mechanical failure. Now, trial 3. Trial 3 was interesting. Wait. Virgil, what is that?
It looks like a gathering of ants.
Well, I can see that, but what... agitated some of the local fauna, so... That's enough for today, Burgle. Science! Has been behaving strangely. I have noted in some of our interactions that he has been taking liberties with my instructions besides his usual displays of incompetence. But just the other day, I heard him humming a tune about grilling. He thought I could not hear him, but I did. And I have told him again and again to eliminate that unnecessary function from his programming, and yet still I know he harbors secret thoughts of grilling. Oh. I was certainly right to isolate him from the experiments. One can only imagine how his malformed programming could be contaminating my research. I'll need to review my security protocols to make sure no further contamination occurs. The security cameras are now installed across the yard, and I've assigned Burgle to overseeing Tasty and Arker operations. A little insurance that my progress on raw science enrichment doesn't fall into the wrong hands. Neither Ominent, nor Insect, nor Robot will have access to my research now.